Hello and welcome back to our channel. Today we are diving into the world of anti-spasmodic drugs. These medications play a crucial role in managing condition that involves muscle spasm, cramps and similar discomforts. We'll explore what anti-spasmodic drugs are, their classification, how they work. If you're interested in pharmacology or medicine, stick around. First, let's define what antispasmodic drugs are. Antispasmodic drugs वो medications होती हैं जो आपके muscle spasm में relief पहुँचाती हैं. These drugs acts on various type of muscle including smooth muscles found in organs like intestine, bladder, uterus as well as skeletal muscles. Antispasmodic drugs का use IBS, dyspepsia or other gastrointestinal disorders ko treat karne mein hota hai. In this video, we'll understand the classification, mechanism of action and pharmacological properties of antispasmodic agents. So please watch this video till the end and if you like this video, then hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more such medical content. Now let's move on to the classification of antispasmodic agents. They are broadly classified into two groups. First, neurotropic or anti-cholinergic antispasmodics. These drugs block your acetylcholine or muscarinic receptors ko block karke apna action show karte hain, and thus they reduce spasm in smooth muscles. Neurotropic antispasmodic ke examples hain hyoscine, jise scopolamine bhi kehte hain, atropine, dicyclomine and oxybutynin. Second category is myotropic antispasmodics. These drugs act by directly acting on the smooth muscles. ये directly smooth muscles पे act करते हैं ताकि spasm में relief पहुँचा सकें without affecting our nervous system. Examples include papaverine, mebivirine, elaverine and pinavirine. Now we'll understand the mechanism of action of neurotropic antispasmodics. So how do they work? As you can see in the diagram, आप देख सकते हैं muscarinic acetylcholine receptor is present and you can see there is a small molecule which is called ACH, that is acetylcholine. तो acetylcholine इस receptor पे जाके bind करता है and it causes muscle contractions. But हमारा neurotropic antispasmodic agent इस binding को ब्लॉक कर देता है जिसकी वजह से रिलैक्सेशन होती है स्मूथ मसल्स में एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स रिलीफ फ्रॉम स्पैज्म. नाउ व्हाट आर द फार्माकोलॉजिकल इफेक्ट्स? इट विल डिक्रीज स्मूथ मसल टोनिंग मोटिलिटी, इट विल रिड्यूस सेक्रेशन इन द गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टाइनल ट्रैक्ट एंड इट विल कॉज एंटी स्पैस्मोडिक इफेक्ट ऑन ब्लैडर एंड बिलियरी ट्रैक्ट. Now we'll understand the mechanism of action for myotropic antispasmodics. ये directly smooth muscle fibers पे act करते हैं. इनका directly autonomic nervous system में कोई role नहीं होता है. हमारी muscle fibers में intracellular calcium levels को interfere करते हैं और phosphodiesterase को inhibit करते हैं, which leads to muscle relaxation. Now what are the pharmacological effects? They cause direct relaxation of smooth muscle cells. It will reduce gastrointestinal motility and spasm and provides relief from visceral pain and discomfort. Pharmacology of neurotropic antispasmodics. Ab hum inke examples ki pharmacology ko samjhenge. First, hyoscine. Orally well absorbed hote hain and via transdermal routes. They are widely distributed and crosses the blood-brain barrier. लीवर में मेटाबोलाइज होते हैं, एक्सक्रीट थ्रू यूरिन. इनके साइड इफ़ेक्ट्स इंक्लूड करते हैं ड्राई माउथ, ब्लर्ड विजन, कॉन्स्टिपेशन, यूरिनरी रिटेंशन एंड कन्फ्यूजन. सेकेंड, डाइसाइक्लोमीन. दे आर रैपिडली अब्जॉर्ब फ्रॉम गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टाइनल ट्रैक्ट, थ्रू आउट बॉडी में डिस्ट्रीब्यूट होते हैं एंड दे क्रॉस द ब्लड ब्रेन बैरियर. पार्शली मेटाबोलाइज होते हैं लीवर में एंड एक्सक्रीट होते हैं यूरिन में. इनके साइड इफ़ेक्ट्स इंक्लूड करते हैं डिजीनेस, ड्राई माउथ, ब्लड विजन, नॉजिया एंड कॉन्स्टिपेशन. Pharmacology of myotropic antispasmodics. First, papaverine. They are well absorbed from gastrointestinal tract, widely distributed hote hain by body tissues mein, metabolize honge liver mein, excrete through urine. Inke side effects include karte hain hypertension, tachycardia, dizziness and nausea. Second, mebivirine. They are rapidly absorbed from gastrointestinal tract, distributed in body tissues, liver mein metabolize honge, primarily through hydrolysis and excrete in urine. Generally well tolerated hote hain, but side effects may include gastrointestinal disturbances jaise ki nausea or constipation. Let's understand the clinical uses of antispasmodic agents. First, gastrointestinal disorders. Antispasmodics ka commonly use muscle spasm ko treat karne mein hota hai, including irritable bowel syndrome IBS, dyspepsia, peptic ulcer disease for neurotropic agents and biliary colic. Second, genitourinary disorders. Kuch antispasmodic jaise ki oxybutynin in spasm mein relief provide karte hain in genitourinary tract, including overactive bladder and uretric colic. Third, motion sickness and post-operative nausea. Neurotropic antispasmodics jaise ki scopolamine ka use motion sickness or post-operative nausea and vomiting ko prevent karne ke liye bhi hota hai. Importance of antispasmodic agents. First, gastrointestinal relief. Antispasmodic agents smooth muscle spasm ko manage karne mein ek vital role play karte hain, especially in gastrointestinal tract, which helps in providing relief from discomfort and thus improving quality of life. Second, targeted treatments. Classification of antispasmodics two categories mein divided hai, neurotropic and myotropic agents mein, jo ki allow karti hai more targeted and effective treatments ke liye, taki wo specific mechanism ko address kar paye aur specific muscle spasm ko treat kar sake. Third, ongoing research. Continuous research and development is field mein ho rahi hai, which is providing a promising result in effectively managing muscle spasm, thus also providing effective antispasmodic treatment with fewer side effects, plus patient outcome or enhancement in managing the muscle spasm related disorders, isme improvement dekhi ja rahi hai. Coming to conclusion, antispasmodic drugs vital tools hain in managing variety of medical conditions that involves muscle spasm and cramps. By understanding their classifications, mechanism, uses and potential side effects, we can better appreciate their role in clinical practice. So, what are the key takeaways from this video? First, definition. Antispasmodic agents wo drugs hain jo ki muscle spasm mein relief pahunchate hain, particularly in gastrointestinal tract. Inki classification ko samjha, jo ki two parts mein divided hai, neurotropic, anticholinergic aur myotropic, based on their mechanism of action. Pharmacology ki baat kare to agar hum antispasmodics ki pharmacokinetics aur unke side effects ko samajh lete hain, then it is crucial for their effective and safe use. Clinical uses. Antispasmodics use hote hain to treat various gastrointestinal, genitourinary, motion sickness related disorders. Thanks for watching. If you found this video informative, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to our channel for more videos on pharmacology and medicine. If you have any question on topics you would like us to cover, leave a comment below. Until next time, stay healthy and stay informed.